The British pound opens up the week moving lower, trading all the way down to 128.07, the lowest we've seen since July 10th. But then things turned around. We saw the pound moving higher, getting north of 128.60, but holding there just the same. It was slightly lower on the session. Really what happened was we saw things moving lower in the morning, then the dollar gains that we saw also in the morning failed to hold. We saw the dollar coming off its highs that helped boost the pound higher. Again, seeing the pound move higher off the lows, but still settling slightly lower on the session. Now, a lot happening this week. We have a Fed meeting on Wednesday where the Fed is not expected to cut rates. However, the Fed is expected to start cutting rates in the third quarter. Alongside of that, on Thursday, we'll have a Bank of England meeting where earlier we saw rate cut odds very low. Now we've seen them kind of scooting higher, now north of 50-50. So it is not a slam dunk yet, but we are seeing those rate cut odds for the Bank of England creeping higher. And that'll be something to watch, obviously, on Thursday as well. But again, seeing the pound opened up the week just shy of unchanged, slightly lower from Friday's close. Now, what does this mean for volatility? Well, check out that CVOL index over at cmegroup.com. You will see that volatility was bid this morning as the aforementioned major events coming down the pipe this week. We have FOMC, we have Bank of England, and don't forget on Friday, we have non-farm payroll. So a lot happening, a lot of that event risk being priced into the market, seeing volatility reflect that moving higher to start the week. Lastly, let's talk about positioning. What are speculators doing? Well, speculators are doing what they've been doing since mid-May, and that's adding to their net long positions. Recall back in April, pound speculators were actually net short, so they flipped in May to net long, and they've been continuing that trend ever since. Now seeing net long positions the most in over 30 years, according to Bloomberg data. So opening up the week, the pound moves lower, then creeps back higher, still closes lower on the day ahead of a very busy week with a central bank meeting here with the Fed. And don't forget Thursday's Bank of England meeting where rate cut odds have been rising, as well as Friday's non-farm payroll.